Dusty Nicol from Chaarat Gold is with me on Skype this morning. Dusty, good morning to you.
Good morning to you, Andrew. Nice to see you again. Greetings from Tulkubash.
And good to catch up. Look, the 2019 exploration program that's off and running. You're on site, clearly. Nine rigs turning at the moment.
Yeah, it is. I'm just down from the hill. We have nine rigs turning right now. We're about 3,800 meters into what will be a minimum 20,000 meter program this year. Three more rigs coming. We'll have at least 12 turning within a couple of weeks. Very excited about what we're seeing so far. We announced some results a couple of days ago. We're getting some nice results from within what we've already defined as the main pit area. This is adding mineralization in zones that were previously classed as waste. It will not only add ounces, it will help with strip ratio, it will help with project economics. We're also starting to get into some of the exciting exploration in the northeast part of the project where we started adding some serious mineralization last year. We have one very nice hole already. It's 19.5 meters at 2.2 grams per ton. It's on the edge of one of our currently defined pits. You know, I always try to make this point when I talk to you about Tulkubash. It's important to remember all of these resource and reserve statements are snapshots in time. This project is growing very quickly. It's on a very steep part of the value addition curve. And we expect with every resource and reserve update to have added a serious amount of ounces and greatly improved project economics.
And it's a total of 20,000 meters you're looking to drill as part of this program, are you?
Yeah, it'll be 20,000, which is about what we drilled last year. And I think to give some context for this, last year we spent direct exploration costs were $7.4 million. We added 650,000 ounces of gold. That was a discovery cost of $11.40 per ounce. This one was one of the most successful programs in my career. It was by quite a ways the lowest discovery cost of anything I've done in my 44 years in gold exploration. One way to look at this is to say we spent $7.4 million. We added 1.5 years to Tulkubash mine life. And that's our recently published updated feasibility study. With a free cash flow of $45 million a year, that translates to $65 million of additional cash coming from a $7.4 million investment. So close to a 9x return, cash on cash. I'm a geologist, not a financial guy, but I think I can say that's a good return by just about anyone's standards.
And so you'd expect investors to be pleased with that?
I would hope so. I think if an investor is in this or wants to be in the gold business, the steepest part of the value addition curve is always an exploration. And I think we're a shining example of that. I'm very comfortable saying that we expect similar, if not greater, results this year. I know at least one of the times that you and I have talked about Tulkubash, we've talked about this concept of this type of gold deposit swelling and pinching along a structure. We had clearly a swollen part or a pearl in what is now the main pit. Still some gold, but a little bit leaner and skinnier for about 1,000 meters beyond that. We still have some pits in that, but nothing that compares to the million same pit. But now everything we're seeing in the field, everything we're seeing from the drill core tells me that we're getting into another major zone that could, in fact, compete with main pit in size and grade. So I'm very optimistic about what we're going to get this year. Now, a point I'd like to make is we are focusing, of course, on adding indicated resource that can be converted to reserve to further extend mine life and enhance project economics. Another interesting part, though, is we are beginning to recognize that Tulkubash is not only one deposit or one set of deposits where we are now. It's clearly an emerging district. I think it will compare with districts like the Carlin Trend in Nevada. We have 24 kilometers of mineralization, favorable geology. We've only explored 4 kilometers of it. We're beginning to do some serious work this year looking at the rest of the district. We're not spending a great deal of money on it because our focus right now is very much on short-term value addition for our shareholders. But putting a little bit of money now into taking a longer-term view of how this district can become a cluster of deposits as we work in the next few years, I'm very optimistic that this will emerge as a major, and not only single deposit discovery, but a major emerging world-class gold district.
What's the resource that you're sitting on at the moment? Is it 1.6 million ounces?
Yeah, we're just over 1.6 million right now. I'm comfortable that we will exceed by a ways. We'll exceed 2 million for the year. You know, if you do the math, I say we'll do at least what we did last year. That would take us to 2.25. So I think that exceeding 2 million is a very conservative expectation for the year. The other interesting thing is, as we're learning more about the deposit, I think that our resource to reserve conversion percentage will increase. As we're moving northeast along strike, the topography is in our favor. Some of the mineralization that we're intercepting now is shallower, so we'll just by definition have a lower strip ratio than what we've had before. And interestingly, as we move northeast, we're getting higher grade, and very significantly for heap leach project, we're getting more oxidation. There's some geological reasons for that I won't bore you with during this conversation, but I'm quite optimistic that not only will we add mineralization, but that the tonnages we add will be both higher grade and more oxidized, and therefore give better metallurgical recovery on the heap. Right now, this is just a trend we're seeing. I can't document that it will continue, but I'm quite optimistic about that.
And we can expect, some steady news flow in the coming weeks and months as to the results of the drilling?
Yeah, as we get information that is significant and we can start interpreting it, we'll put it out, and I'll always be happy to come see you and talk with you about it.
Dusty, good to get an update. Look, thanks very much for your time.
Thanks so much, Andrew. It's always a pleasure.